Men get retroactively jealous of a woman's past because they think about how much hypothetical fun they would have had if they did what she did. But most women would trade their whole past for one loving partner for life. It's a huge difference in perspectives.
So let's sort out two things here. Because I post this, retroactive jealousy, though, is I think she did X, Y, and Z, so she's going to go do it with someone else. Again, I'm holding her back, or I'm not going to be good enough. There's a massive pressure on the guy, especially if she's had experiences he hasn't had. Massive pressure on the guy to try to perform, perform, perform. He sees, again, women and well, she wants this. They are always happy when they do this.
Okay, ladies, so the comment section here is truly, truly telling. It is so telling and informative. And, you know, as we continue and we learn about this species, the male species, we start seeing the patterns, right? It's like they repeat themselves over and over again. They're not very complicated, especially, and it's that much easier, especially because they tell on themselves. They literally will just say it out in the public forum, on the internet, y'all. It's wild. So let's take a look. It's so interesting. So this is a male, and these two have primarily a following of males. So their following is primarily made up of males. Loser males, might I add. I think they're probably a part of the red pill space, actually. So these males are saying, I just wish I could be the first. It hurts for no reason. Y'all, look at this. It's wild. I'm telling you, I can't make this stuff up. They literally are like putting this out here and anyone could just find it and be like, oh, this is what this species really is, you know? Side note, ladies, I'm gonna need y'all to start cracking up books open, crack open dictionaries, because I've had at least two people or three mention the fact that I call this group, the male species, a species. Like, if you are not gonna bother to fact check your own self, then don't bother me, please. Like, keep your opinions to yourself. I posted the definition to make it easier if you are one of those people on my communities page section, because all you have to do is literally Google the definition of species. But I posted the explanation in my communities page section, so you can go there after this video if you need help, right? So anyway, even if she were to tell you, you're the best I've ever had, no matter what, it will still haunt you. Y'all, I'm telling you. I bring this stuff to y'all because I need you to see that it's not me saying these things. They're telling us. They're saying it. They're admitting it, right? In what they, in their mind, think makes sense, I suppose. But objectively speaking, it's totally wild. It makes it to where no women should be caught with any males. If the male isn't, some women are more generous and say 10% of males, only about 10% of males are able to keep up with the evolution of women as women continue to evolve. I don't know. I kind of stick to around that 5%, and I don't really believe that they evolve or keep up with women's evolution. I just think that they put in a little bit more effort. The 5% of males out of 100%. Leave it in the comments below what percentage you think it is. There was a point where I thought it had to be 1%. And that goes beyond financial. So we're talking about everything, not just like financial earnings, right? Character, intelligence, ethics, kindness. We're talking about everything, right? Yeah, look at that. You just can't ever feel like you are enough. Yeah, oh my God, y'all. So whenever you Oh my God, this is the type of stuff I try to bring to you because it's wild. Like when I do research on this for the videos, the stuff I find, y'all, it's not about her cheating or not feeling good enough. It's about whether she gave another guy a better time than she's giving me and wondering why. And this has 43 likes. These other ones, you see how they have like hundreds of likes on here? I'm telling you, 4B, because we don't need the male species for anything. And why are we going to bring children into this world to live amongst these predators? They're pure, they're an unempathetic, pure predators. Scum. The scum of their own species. It's wild, you know? I just wish she did it all with me first because a new experience, you always remember it. And when it's intimate, it depends or it deepens your connection to each other. So they're jealous of you. And I keep trying to tell you, they are jealous. They will tell you, no, it's because you're not good enough. It's because you did this, blah, blah, blah. No, it's they're just jealous of you. They're jealous that you're able to do these things. And it's so wild because they are the ones that constructed this patriarchy. So what the hell is their problem? You know? So this person says, no, I really think purity is good. Meanwhile, this individual is not pure himself, but yet wants purity or what he considers quote unquote as purity, but yet he is no virgin. I just need you to see the caliber. If you pursue this species, this especially this caliber, and you listen to the nonsense that they tell you, then you know, just understand that you're swimming in the bottom of the bottom of the barrel. Unfortunately for you. Because it's like they're not hiding it, y'all. They're not hiding it. I seriously just don't understand why they can't just like wait. It's seriously not that hard to wait for first experiences with someone. Y'all, I can't even believe I stumbled upon this. Oh my God, y'all, I can't. Oh! Y'all, look at this. And aren't they the same ones that started plastering billboards all over the place saying celibacy is not the answer? But this is their true feelings. It comes, see, their true thoughts and the truth comes out within these spaces where they think they're safe. 161 likes. So, ladies, there's no more waiting. It's just 4B. This is the quality that's out there. It's just 4B. Now, if you somehow stumble upon a 5%er, I don't even know, girl. I can't, in all good faith and consciousness, tell you to go move forward with it. All I can say is take your time in vetting to really make sure. And when I say take your time, I mean 1, 2, 3 years because you don't even need to marry them. I wouldn't marry, but look, they're telling you. Oh my God, look at Molly the Pygmisha. I hope he never thinks I'd leave him for something. Like, they don't even want you here. This is their space. They don't want you here. You got 21 likes, and all these other comments have like hundreds. So, Pygmisha is going to have to be washed away with them. And mind you, they have Pygmisha. They can choose from Pygmisha. But for some reason, they insist on continuing to harass the rest of women that aren't Pygmisha, that aren't, they don't think this way. It's like you can really leave us alone because you really have other options. You have Molly. Right? But from what I've been hearing, they're not only not choosing Molly, but it's getting worse. From what I've been hearing, it's actually getting worse out in real life beyond this digital screen. It's actually getting worse, where males are starting to treat women even worse because they're starting to feel the lack of access to them, which is wild, right? Because they can always just go with Pygmalion. I don't really understand what the discrepancy is. Yeah, men and their overuse of biology is such a stupid argument. Jesus, shut up. Yeah, they're such idiots. It's like, I can't. Oh my God. Like, there's no way. They're just so below standards that make sense. Like, the way they think is not smart. They're just so dumb. Like, I swear. Like, in this same video, it would have been too long, so it's not something that I included in there, but in this same video, he was like, yeah, I understand that there's a biological reason why males seek out women that don't have plenty of partners in the past or haven't had plenty of partners in the past. There's no biological reason. These are the reasons. None of these reasons are biological. None of these reasons are biological. It's because you are not good enough and you know it. So instead of continuing to pursue that which you know you are not good enough for, how about you leave it alone? But, you know, they're like, oh, it's just biology. No, biology says that the Y chromosome is continuing to deteriorate, has been deteriorating and degenerating for millions of years now. And that actually the Y chromosome is going extinct as we speak with every XY chromosome that is birthed. That is biology. That is science. What you're talking about is your incapability to be good enough. It just sucks for you. People use religion to justify their crazy views. Yeah. Any reason that comes to play is from a woman. Any reasonable comment, which we've only seen two so far, because all the rest have been from males. Research shows that both men and women benefit from having a low number of partners. I don't really understand why we're focusing on just women on this topic. Women don't even care. Like, women are just not going to choose you because you're a crappy individual. That's the end of it. There's no excuse that you can make to yourself. There's nothing that you can do. Your life just sucks. You know? Misogynistic people and sexism, unfortunately. Yeah. Men care more, I think. Yep. To men, therapy is a great thing and can help you from pushing away your future partner with this issue that is in your head. Like, it's so funny. Like, wow. What the literal? It's wild. And the women are like, thank you. And then there's hearts everywhere. Like, ew, these males are just so subpar, y'all. I cannot. Male inferiority complex. Exactly. Males, please stop asking for a woman with low numbers when you yourself are not a virgin. Like, literally. This is from a doctor, apparently. So freaking funny and ridiculous. Sounds like one seriously insecure dude. Yeah, no kidding.
I actually have some mental health stuff to talk about.
Okay.
First one is called Men Are Jealous of You.
I mean, I've only been saying it since the womb.
You know when people are like, oh, like, you're too much of a woman for him, or like, he can't handle you?
Yeah.
That never made sense to me. I'm like, oh, so like, he's scared because I'm good?
Yeah.
Like, or he's scared that I'm successful? Like, mm-hmm. Men aren't scared that you're successful. You don't make them feel good about themselves.
Yeah.
But we never phrase it in that way. We're always like, oh, like, you're too much for him. And that makes you feel like you did something wrong.
Mm-hmm.
These men are out here jealous of you. And he'll choose a girl he's not jealous of. Yeah. And I don't mean like she's less than me, but like whatever his own demons are, mm-hmm. he can handle her better. Mm-hmm. And like that's something we really have to keep an eye out for in these streets.
Ladies, walk with me. Every 3 to 5 days, somebody's son comes on here and tries to rage bait us with their unresolved mommy issues in the name of opinions on women. Usually target our appearance, our age, our lifestyle, hairstyles, pretty much everything about us, because they hate us. And every 3 to 5 days, like clockwork, we are responding to them. Here's my thing. It is time we go bar for bar with these caliber of men. An example, if a man comes on here and he's like, I don't like your BBL. I don't like the shape of your head. Why does your head look so strong? Matter of fact, now that we're on the topic of you, why does your skin look like dehydrated elephant hide? Yeah, you look like you need to be steeped in fabric softener and then forgotten there for like 14 days just so your skin can start to mimic something that once knew what moisturizer was. Is that a belly I see, sir? Do you have a belly? Have you ever heard of Dr. Miami? Go see him. As for the Toronto special, allegedly. Matter of fact, I'll tag him for you. Is that a double chin under that beard? Did your arm move? Is that flabber? You're flabby. You have flabber. And I'm flabbergasted at the temerity of you to talk about a woman's appearance looking like that. Oh, women over 30, you're a man over 30 who is not married with kids. Are you a whore? Are you the whore of Babylon? You must be. And ladies, you might be thinking, Ryan, I'm not going to be arguing with this man. You don't have to, sweetheart. You don't have to. I am the strongest soldier in this fight. Robo, shake it, ba 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 ba. I am the strongest soldier in this fight. Put me in the front lines. Tag me. I'll tell him his problem. I would tell him exactly what the color and the size of his problem is. Put me in the front lines. The commandant in chief of the bar for bar army for the girls, by the girls, brought to you by therapy. Therapy, a thing you need, but you're probably never going to get. Are you?
If someone had told me that guys can sometimes be jealous of women, I wouldn't have believed it until I experienced it myself. There was this particular guy who would flirt with me and, you know, he would do all that flirtatious stuff, right? But he would never ask me out. So I just thought, okay, maybe he's just shy or I don't know. Whatever it was, I didn't really care. And I'm not about to help you to talk to me, okay? If you don't know how to approach me at this point, that's on you. So as time went on, we would talk. But when other guys would talk to me, this guy would get jealous. This guy would not like it. When he sees other people come to me, because the thing is, I'm that kind of person, I don't look for attention. Attention looks for me. If I'm in a building, like, I don't talk much. I'm not even loud. I wouldn't even say a word, but people will know I'm there. And I'm not just saying this to brag, but this is how I am. And this has been happening to me like all my life. And this particular guy I'm talking about, he's attention seeking kind of guy, a bit insecure. And so when I get these attention, when I get people come up to me without me having to do anything or say anything, he would get triggered by that. And I thought, okay, maybe he just doesn't like other guys talking to me. But when he saw the girl that he wanted, he went after her, he pursued her, you know, made it clear to her. So I'm like, all this while, it wasn't like you had a problem trying to approach me, but you just wanted something that you didn't have, which was attention. He wanted attention. One day, me and this guy were walking, and people were looking at us, and he would look at me because he knew they were looking at us because of me, not because of him. And I say this to say, ladies, you have to be careful who you surround yourself with, because guys don't get that much attention. Like, do you get what I'm saying? Beautiful women, pretty women get attention. And when a pretty, beautiful woman is walking beside a man, people will look. Do you know what I mean? That affects his insecurity or confidence or whatever. So don't just make yourself available to just any man. If a man wants to be your friend, you don't have to be around him 24/7, because some guys can really, really hide you. And if you're not careful, all that glow and all that energy, you're putting it into somebody else, and that person can feel it, and it will just lead to more jealousy, and sometimes the person can destroy you.
The person who sits on the throne in the heavens being the cosmos, or the cosmological womb, the macrocosm to our microcosm, the ruler of the universe is not who you think it is. It is not a man sitting on a throne in the heavens. It is actually the Great Mother. And because we have been told this lie, this is the reason why a lot of people believe that a man can father a child, or that the child is within the seed of the man, and that women are just incubators, that there's no life within the egg. But understand that the egg is already a life form.
Can't you see? I'm calling. A guy like you should wear a warning. It's dangerous. I'm falling.
You know that guy that's going viral around suggesting that some women are going to have to settle? What I'm also realizing is a lot of women have been thinking about marrying other women just on some romanticizing the friendship, like a life partner, someone that can carry their weight even if they wanted to have kids, and they can like link up and have their need, their physical needs met in other way if they don't choose to scissor amongst themselves. So anyway, women are doing well. And what's also interesting is that the matriarchy is rising, evident by the women that are choosing to maintain the power and their personal growth through partnerships that are better aligned with them. And as a result, they're considering marrying amongst themselves. And technically, there is a tradition within Africa where it's matrilineal and also matriarchal, and the women marry other women to maintain the wealth and the power dynamic. So I say this all to say, I love this for us, because settle where?
Hola, hola. Hi, my loves. How are you doing today? So this is actually a really good idea. I was listening to this and I was like, that's freaking brilliant. This is brilliant. Now, I'm not saying that in regards to when it comes to kids, because honestly, I don't understand the whole wanting other people to help you raise your kids when you're the one that decided to have kids. I don't get that. But in terms of building wealth, in terms of especially generational wealth, in terms of companionship, maintaining the peace, like why didn't we think of this before? This is like so smart. Like, what? And you know what? It's been right in front of our faces, because there's quite a bit of content. Well, not quite a bit, because there's not that many twins in the world. And not only that, twins that make online content, but there's online content of twins that I watch all the time. And like, they, you know, will make content about going on vacation together, they live together. And so it's really a very, very similar concept, but an even stronger concept, because you're literally locking in the wealth. You're not spreading it with males. You're not sharing it with males as it should be, because women are the ones that worked for it. We worked for that wealth. We worked our butts off underneath a patriarchy, which is this world that males built, which is a world that literally detests and hates women, despite the fact that even before BC, right, even before all the stuff that's written in the Bible, women are the god, right? Goddesses are god, right? Nowadays, with everything written in the Bible, they've literally, from what I've been researching, y'all, it's wild. From what I've been researching, they took what the women created and wrote about women being god. And I guess nowadays we would call them goddesses. And the males took this. They couldn't even bother to write their own content, right? And over thousands of years, they changed details in it to make it to where anything that was powerful, they put a male in there. Anything that was subjected, they put the woman in there. Like, it's, y'all, it's too much for this video, what I've been finding out.
Before the patriarchy took over, and before there was a sky daddy, like a male monotheistic god, the rest of human civilization was actually all about goddess worship. The rest of, like, most of human history was actually more about seeing that God was a feminine energy. That's why we still call Mother Earth, Mother Earth, Mother Nature. Like, goddess worship actually is what we need to go back to, because goddess worship means that you have reverence for creation. You have reverence for the land. I think it's really where we need to be at is matriarchal systems. The world will be a better place when we have the matriarchy instead of the patriarchy. Because feminine leadership is about the collective instead of the individual.
Exactly. It's time women realize their true divine power. Wow, this has been cooking for years, y'all. So little by little, one woman at a time, right? I love that so many women are starting to wake up and catch on. Literally, y'all, when I tell you, ugh, too long for this video, but even without knowing how in-depth this lie that we've been fed goes, I started to reason in that way, because I was like, these lies don't make any sense. I'm seeing the males right in front of me, and they are nothing, nothing like you're trying to portray them. There's no way. And then I'm seeing the amount of feedback from other women. There's no way that these males are anything related to anything we're supposed to be looking up to or even relying on. And then I started to think, then what is it? And it just naturally led me to the conclusion, well, that which gives life, right? The planet, nature, earth. When it comes to protection, animals, women, kids, but none of these things can be done successfully underneath a patriarchy. Unless the woman and each woman chooses to live outside of said patriarchy and maybe even use these stupidity of rules and laws of the patriarchy to the matriarchy's advantage. So the marriage thing, like the video that we saw, where women are starting to wisen up, because you got to think about it. What does marriage have to do with love? Marriage literally has nothing to do with love. Marriage is a legal contract. So you want to continue to build the matriarchy, you want to continue to build wealth, then you marry a woman that's worth building that with, right? Very interesting thoughts to process through, right? I never knew this. Yeah, of course, because males do everything in their power. You know that the males literally destroyed all the goddess statues, all the goddess shrines, in order to implement what we have now, which is the patriarchy. They literally destroyed everything and killed everyone. It was like nothing but war after war after war, y'all. That's how we got to the place where we are now. It's wild when you start questioning things that you have been too scared in your own mind to question for years. You start finding out, uh-oh, the truth is dark. The truth is dark. Even in this comment thread, you can see how different it is. Heart emojis, smiling emojis, flower emojis. It's just a totally different vibe. Excluding the ones that can't be saved. I know some ladies feel like maybe they can be saved. I don't feel like they can be saved. The Pikmishas and the older generation of ladies that were fully and have already been fully indoctrinated and brought up in the patriarchy will just have to be taken care of by nature. Pikmishas and those other women. The only ones that are capable of quote unquote being saved are the ones that are capable of doing it for themselves because they want it for themselves. That's it. And that's a very, very small number of them, because most of them will just come into women's spaces, women that are trying to create more and threaten that space, you know?
Men are so jealous of women, especially beautiful women. And the root of all of that anger and all of that jealousy is the patriarchy, which is, guess what? Set up by men. The reality is that men are expected to wake up early every single day and go to work and get a paycheck and pay for bills, not only for themselves, but for their wives, their girlfriends, any future kids they might have. They have to do hard manual labor or work their way up a corporate ladder. But women don't have to do that. And it makes y'all so upset that girls like me or other beautiful girls can capitalize off of our looks and make an amazing living. And I'm not saying at all that just because a girl is pretty, she doesn't have to work hard or she isn't a hard worker. If anything, you kind of have to work a little bit harder to get over the bias of being pretty. But there's no denying that there are so many life advantages to being attractive. This goes for men and women, but for whatever reason, it makes men so upset. The fact that I make the money that I do and I have the lifestyle that I have because of my looks and what I post on social media really upsets y'all. Because y'all wish y'all had it this easy, and y'all don't, so you're angry. I get it.
Men are jealous of women. It is the root of all of our issues as gender.
Ladies, this is a reminder that anytime a guy comes at you with the, you're gonna die alone with a bunch of cats, you're gonna get old, and you're gonna die alone, it is projection. See, we're not at risk of being alone. There's a reason why there's no female loneliness epidemic. There's a male loneliness epidemic, and for good reason. The fact is, we always have options. And if you're a younger woman in your 20s, I want you to really listen to this, because I wish someone told me this when I was in my 20s. You don't need to try so hard. You don't need to try that hard at all. You just gotta exist. It doesn't matter how old you get. It doesn't matter how conventionally pretty you are or how ugly you are. It doesn't matter how thin, how fat. You will always have options. We are the yay or nay to the coitus, and they can't stand it. No matter how hard they try to ingrain in us that the best thing we can do is find a husband, no matter how hard they try to legislate our reproductive rights, it is ours, and it always has been. Anytime a man tells you that you're gonna regret not getting married or regret not having a family, and oh, you know, once your youth is gone, no one's gonna want you when you're older, it is projection. And it's usually right-wing politicians or pastors like, oh, who's that guy, Mark Driscoll? Ugh. Ladies, you don't need to hurry. You will always have options. They're just not always great options. If a woman is single, it's because she chooses to be single. Fortunately, there are still a lot of quality progressive guys out there. Like, I've got a great partner who understands all of this just fine. So ladies, don't ever settle for less, and do not ever get your validation from a man who tells you that your youth is important or that your looks are important. They're not.